Good morning, or good afternoon, or good evening, whenever you're watching this. I am Amy Smith of Daughters of the King Bible Study, and we're affiliated with Calvary Chapel River Oaks, which is on 232 Nelson Street, Cartersville. And today I'll be talking about chapter 20, John chapter 20. First, I want to say a prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for anointing me with your word. I may go out to everyone who needs to hear it. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, John chapter 20, verse 1. Now, the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb early, while it was still dark, and saw that the stone had been taken away from the tomb. Then she ran and came to Simon Peter and to the other disciples whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken away the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." The reference verse to this is Matthew chapter 28, verse 1. Now, after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. Okay, Mark chapter 16, verse 1. Now when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices that they might come and anoint him. Now verse, okay, back to verse 3 of our text. Peter therefore went out, and the other disciple, and were going to the tomb. So they both ran together, and the other disciples, and the other disciple outran Peter, and came to the tomb first. The other disciple was John. Verse 5, and he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying there, yet he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb, and he saw the linen clothes lying there, and the head and the handkerchief that had been round his head, not lying with the linen cloth, but folded together in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who came to the tomb first, went in also, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not know the scriptures, that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciple went away again to their own houses. And a reference verse is John chapter 11, verse 44. And he who had died came out bound hand and foot with grave clothes, and his face was wrapped with a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Loose him and let him go." And this is referring to when Lazarus had been buried, and Lazarus came out of his tomb. And I think I had mentioned that when someone is first saved, if they've been born again, We have to disciple them and help them out of their grave clothes. And then another reference verse is John chapter 19, verse 40. Then they took the body of Jesus and brought it in strips of linen with the spices, as the custom of the Jews to bury. And then another reference verse is Luke chapter 24, verse 12. But Peter arose and ran to the tomb, and stooping down, he saw a linen cloth laying by themselves, and he departed, marveling to himself at what had happened. The verse 11 of our text. But Mary stood outside by the tomb, weeping. And as she wept, she stooped and looked into the tomb. And she saw two angels in white sitting, one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. Then they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? In reference verse Mark chapter 16, verse 5. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man clothed in long white robes, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. Now, verse 13b of our text. She said to them, "Because they have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." Now, when she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there and did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you seeking?" She, supposing him to be the gardener, said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, "Rabboni," which is to say, teacher. Okay, oops, Jesus said to her, "Do not cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." And I'm pausing there, and I just think it's wonderful that Jesus was calling his disciples brethren. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord and that he had spoken these things to her. Then the same day, at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his sides. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. and reference to this is Mark chapter 16, verse 14. Later, he appeared to the 11 as they sat at the table, and he rebuked their unbelief and hardness of heart because they did not believe these who had seen him after he had risen. Reference verse to this is Luke chapter 24, verse 36. Now, as they said these things, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them, and he said to them, "Peace to you." Now, verse 21 of our text. So Jesus said to them again, "Peace to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Rejoice." Oh, receive. You can rejoice when you receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Now Thomas, called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples, therefore, said to him, "We have seen the Lord." And reference verses John chapter 11, verse 16. Then Thomas, who was called the twin, said to his fellow disciples, "Let us also go that we may die with him." Now this is referring to when Lazarus had died, and Thomas is referring to the burial of Jesus, because it says, "Let us go that we may die with him," and "him" is with a capital H. In commentaries of the Blue Letter Bible by David Guzik, Thomas, who's called the twin, church tradition says that Thomas was called the twin because he looked like Jesus, putting him at special risk if anyone among the disciples were potential targets of persecution. It would be the one who looked like Jesus. So he said to them, "Unless I see his hands, the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." This is where we get the phrase "doubting Thomas." And after 8 days, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas with them. Jesus came, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst and said, "Peace to you." Then he said to Thomas, "Reach your finger here and look at my hands, and reach your hand here and put it into my side. Do not be unbelieving, but believing." And Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, Thomas, because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. And a reference verse is 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. For we walk by faith and not by sight. And then 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 8. Whom having not seen you love, though now you do not see him, yet believing, you rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory. And truly, Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book, but there are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ. The Son of God, that believing you may have life in his name. And reference verse to this is John chapter 3, verses 15 and through 16. That whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have lasting life. Another reference verse is John chapter 21, verse 25. And there are also many other things that Jesus did, which, if they were written one by one, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that would be written. Amen. And that Luke chapter 1, verse 4, that you may know the certainty of those things in which you were instructed. And so that does it for John chapter 20. And they call the book of John the love chapter. And Jesus proves himself over and over again. And it talks about the death and the life and resurrection of Jesus. He even says how to be saved. All you have to do is call on the Lord and believe that he is the Son of God and died and raised and rose again. And the a couple of chapters ago, I went through a sinner's prayer. And it could be just very simple. Lord, I am a sinner in the need of a Savior. Come into my heart and be the Lord of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. And next week, I'll be discussing the book of John, chapter 21, which is the last chapter. And that would be the last of the Bible study, at least the Bible study in which God has anointed me to do. And he may raise someone else up. But until next week, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord put his countenance on you and be gracious to you and give you peace. Amen.